Hello friends, welcome back to B2C. In this video, we will discuss the current affairs of May 2nd week, part 1. First is international current affair. The European Union recently approved the request of Norway, Canada and the United States to participate in the Permanent Structured Cooperation Defence Initiative. This will enable all these said countries to now participate in military mobility projects in Europe. This is based on a treaty signed by European Union in 2009 called as Treaty of Lisbon. Nepal's Kami Rita scales Mount Everest for the record 25th time, and he recreated and he broke his own record for the most number of ascents in the world's highest peak. Kami Rita is 51 years old and scaled the Everest first in 1994. Nepali name of Mount Everest is Sagarmatha, and the Tibetan name is Chomolungma. Former Senator Bill Nelson of United States Assembly was sworn in as the 14th Administrator of National Aeronautics and Space Administration under the Joe Biden-Kamala Harris administration. Headquarters of NASA is Washington, D.C., United States of America. Nepal Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli has lost the vote of confidence in the House of Representatives in Nepal's parliament. Capital city of Nepal is Kathmandu and currency is Nepalese rupee. President of Nepal is Bindya Devi Bhandari. We move on to national news, and the only national news here is CBSE, Central Board of Secondary Education, has launched a new app called Dost for Life, and it is a psychology counseling app for students and parents. The CBSE chairman is Manoj Ahuja. We move on to state news. Himachal Pradesh is building forest ponds to harvest rainwater under the Parvat Dhara scheme. This project aims at rejuvenation of water resources and recharging aquifers. Himachal Pradesh governor is Bandaru Dattatreya, and the Himachal Pradesh CM is Jairam Thakur. New Chief Minister sworn in Puducherry, the Union Territory, and his name is N. Rangaswamy. He's a member of All India NR Congress, and the oath was administered by Lieutenant General of Union Territory of Puducherry, Tamilisai Soundararajan. Next news is Himant Biswa Sarma, appointed as the 15th Chief Minister of Assam. He will replace the incumbent Sarbanand Sonowal. Governor of Assam is Jagdish Mukhi. Tripura launches Aura Scholarship Program of Sri Aurobindo Society. The Education Minister of Tripura is Ratan Lal Nath, and he launched the program, and it is aimed at monthly micro scholarships to students in order to motivate them to achieving better success. The Union Territory of Puducherry becomes Har Ghar Jal Union Territory, and it has achieved this feat by 100% piped water connection in the Union Territory. After Goa, Telangana, Andaman, Nicobar, Puducherry becomes the fourth Union State or Union Territory to complete the Union Government's Har Ghar Jal mission. Chief Minister of Puducherry is N. Rangaswamy. We move on to appointments. Ujula Sinha has been appointed as the National President of FICCI, Ladies Organization, FLO, the oldest women-led and women-centric business chamber of Southeast Asia. She became 38th President by taking over as the National President of FICCI, FLO. The organization will aim at enabling an environment that promotes entrepreneurship, industry participation, economic development among women. Next is Indian origin immunologist Shankar Ghosh has been elected to the prestigious National Academy of Sciences in recognition of his work, distinguished and continuing achievements in original research. We move on to defense. Indian Army sets up COVID management cell to greater efficiency in order to coordinate the real-time responses and to address the exponential rise in COVID cases across the country. Next news is another important drug which has been given emergency approval for use by Drug Controller General of India, and that is 2-deoxy-D-glucose, 2D or 2DG, developed by Defence Research and Development Organisation in association with Dr. Reddy's Laboratory, Hyderabad. Chairman of DRDO is Dr. G. Satish Reddy. Headquarters is in New Delhi, established in 1958. Indian and Indonesian Navies conduct exercise in Arabian Sea, known as PASEX. Indian Navy INS Shraddha, an offshore patrol vehicle with Chetak helicopter, participated in the exercise. KRA Sultan Hasuddin from Indonesian Navy, a 90-meter corvette, also took part in the exercise. Indonesian President is Joko Widodo, capital is Jakarta, and currency is Indonesian Rupee. Chief of Naval Staff of India is Admiral Karanbir Singh, and Integrated Headquarters of Ministry of Defence is the headquarters of Navy in New Delhi. Next is the release of the Bollywood actor Kalki Cochin's debut book, which is Elephant in the Womb. We move on to banking news. The Reserve Bank of India sets up an advisory to assist the second regulatory review authority, and it will be headed by SBI Managing Director S. Janaki Raman. 25th RBI Governor is Shaktikanta Das, and RBI was founded in 1st April 1935, Kolkata. RBI explodes Lakshmi Vilas Bank from second schedule of RBI Act after it merged with DBS Bank last year. The Reserve Bank of India appoints Jose J. Kartur as the Executive Director. He has been promoted as the Executive Director, and he was earlier headed the Bangalore Regional Office of RBI. HDFC Bank and Common Service Centers launched Chatbot Eva on CSC Digital Seva Portal to support village-level entrepreneurship. And this initiative will bridge the gap between India and Bharat, urban India, and has been quick to learn and adapt to the digital world, while rural India has faced many challenges as it has lower internet penetration. Headquarters of HDFC Bank is Mumbai, Maharashtra. And MD CEO is Shashidhar Jagadish. Niti Aayog released a report titled Connected Commerce, Creating a Roadmap for Digitally Inclusive Bharat. Niti Aayog has released the report in collaboration with MasterCard. The report identifies that various challenges faced in accelerating digital financial inclusion in India, and also provides recommendation for making digital services accessible to 1.3 billion citizens. Niti Aayog was formed in 1st January 2015. Its headquarters is in New Delhi. And the chairperson of Niti Aayog is Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and the vice chairman is Rajiv Kumar. Padma Kumar Nair appointed as the CEO of National Asset Reconstruction Company. Presently, he is the chief of general manager of Stressed Asset Resolution Group at SBI. United Nations projects India's economy to grow at 10.7% GDP in the calendar year 2021, and it cautioned in the growth outlook of 2021 as Indian economy is highly fragile, as the country was the new hotbed of the COVID-19 pandemic. UN headquarters is in New York, USA, and its Secretary General is Antonio Guterres. Jena Small Finance Bank launches I Choose My Number feature. The new feature allows banks' existing and new customers' opinion to select their favorite number as the savings or current account numbers. We move on to science and technology. The SpaceX, owned by Elon Musk, launches Dog One mission to the moon. First ever commercial lunar payload paid entirely in the cryptocurrency Dogecoin. The satellite is scheduled to be launched in the first quarter of 2022 on board Falcon 9 rocket. The Dogecoin Bitcoin cryptocurrency is entirely funded by Canadian company Geometric Energy Corporation. SpaceX founder is Elon Musk and it was founded in 2002. Headquarters is in California, United States of America. Indian Space Research Organization Vikram Sarabhai Space Center has developed three types of ventilators and oxygen concentrator at a time when the country was facing shortage of medical oxygen. Three devices are Prana, Vayu and Swasta. ISRO chairman is K. Shivan and ISRO headquarters is in Bengaluru, Karnataka. We move on to awards. Naomi Osaka wins top title at 2021 Laureus World Sports Awards. World number two tennis player Naomi Osaka of Japan has been named the Sportswoman of the Year in 2021 Laureus World Sports Awards, and she won the Breakthrough of the Year award also. In the men's category, world number two Rafael Nadal of Spain, the tennis player, won the 2021 Laureus Sportsman of the Year title. Actor Anupam Kher wins Best Actor at the New York City International Film Festival. For the short film, Happy Birthday, IREDA, Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency, has been conferred with the Green Urja Award for being leading public institution in financing institution of renewable energy this year by Indian Chamber of Commerce. IREDA headquarters is in New Delhi and it is founded in 11th March 1987. Summits and conferences. Union Minister for State for Tourism and Culture Prahlad Singh Patel participated in G20 Tourism Ministers Meet held in Italy on 4th May 2021. The dialogue aimed at to collaborate in protecting tourism business jobs and taking initiative to frame policy guidelines to support the sustainable and resilient recovery of travel and tourism as a sector came under severe stress induced by the COVID-19 pandemic. Prime Minister Narendra Modi participates in virtual India-European Union Leaders Meeting. Prime Minister Narendra Modi participated in India-European Union Leaders Meeting held in hybrid format. Indian-European Union Leaders Meeting is hosted by Portugal. President of European Union is Mr. Charles Michel. European Council was founded 9th December 1974. European Union headquarters location is Brussels, Belgium, and it was founded in 1st November 1993. We move on to miscellaneous news. New Delhi ranks 32 in Global Prime Residential Index by Knight Frank. Mumbai in 36th position and Bengaluru in 40th rank. First three cities are Shenzhen, Shanghai and Guangzhou, and all three are in China. Mayflower 400, world's first unmanned vessel to navigate across the Atlantic. It has been built by the marine research organization ProMarine in collaboration with IBM. It will begin its transatlantic voyage on 15th May 2021 to track aquatic animals, analyze plastic in water and study in marine pollution. ProMarine invested $1 million along with global contribution in the form of technology from India, United States and Switzerland to build the ship. IBM Chief CEO Executive is Arvind Krishna. Headquarters is Armok, USA. Indian Navy sets up COVID care center at Bhimunipattanam and it has set up 60-bed COVID care center at INS Kalinga to assist general population dealing with the COVID-19 pandemic. It will be manned by 3 doctors and 10 nursing staff of the community health center. We move on to sports news. The Spanish Grand Prix was won by Lewis Hamilton for the 5th time. Lewis Hamilton represented Mercedes Great Britain. Aryna Sabalenka wins her maiden Madrid Open women's single titles, and she defeated the world number one Ashley Barty of Australia to win 2020 Madrid Open women's single titles. Alexander Zverev beats Matteo Berrettini to win the second Madrid title. Alexander is a German player and he earned his second Mututa Madrid Open title 2021 when he defeated his opponent Matteo Berrettini in the fourth ATP Masters 1000 trophy. ...23-year-old left-arm seamer bowler from Gujarat, Arjun Nagaswala, has been picked as a reserve player in India Test squad named for the World Test Championship final against the New Zealand in Southampton. Pakistan's Babar Azam wins ICC Player of the Month for April 2021. Pakistan skipper Babar Azam has been named ICC Men's Player of Month for April 2021 for his consistent and stellar performance across all formats in the recently concluded series against South Africa. The chairman of ICC is Gray Barclay and CEO is Manu Shwane. Headquarters is in Dubai, United States of America. We move on to important days. World Red Cross and Red Crescent Day, observed on 8th May, and it aims to celebrate the principles of International Red Cross and Red Crescent Movement to reduce suffering of people and enabling them to live a dignified life with independence, humanity, impartiality, universality, unity and neutrality. The theme 2021 for the day is Unstoppable. President of ICRC is Peter Manoron and headquarters of International Red Cross Society is Geneva, Switzerland. World Thalassemia Day, observed on 8th May. The theme for 2021 World Thalassemia Day was Addressing Health Inequalities Across the Global Thalassemia Community. India celebrates National Technology Day on 11th May. On this day marks the successful test firing of Shakti 1 nuclear missile at Indian Army's Pokhran Test Range in Rajasthan. The Shakti, also known as Pokhran nuclear test, was first nuclear test code named Smiling Buddha was carried out in May 1974. National Science Day celebrated all over India on February 28th. International Nurses Day observed globally on 12th May. And this day is observed to commemorate the birth anniversary of Florence Nightingale. The theme of International Nurses Day 2021 is Nurses, a Voice to Lead, a Vision for Future Healthcare. Florence Nightingale is renowned for setting up Nightingale School of Nursing at St. Thomas Hospital in London. She was the first woman awarded the Order of Merit in 1909. International Council of Nurses headquarters is in Geneva, Switzerland. International Council of Nurses was founded in 1899 and the president is Anand Kennedy. Friends, with this we come to the conclusion of this session. Stay tuned for our next session.
If you enjoyed this video, please do like and share. Subscribe to this channel to receive expert tips and guidance for clearing various placement exams. And press the bell icon to receive instant notifications.